Hi, this is Jeff from Evans Tuning. In this video, we're going to be talking about fuel injectors, fuel pumps, and fuel systems in general. So I get a lot of phone calls, a lot of emails asking tech questions for fuel systems. People want to know what size fuel injector I need, what size fuel pump I need, for what horsepower. I tend to look at things a little bit from a different perspective. Then, you know, what fuel injector is going to give me what horsepower? While that is kind of true, a lot of people have the mentality that the bigger is better for a fuel system. So I need the biggest injectors I can get. I need the biggest fuel pump that I can get. And I do recommend people, when they're doing their fuel systems, to oversize your fuel system. You don't want to be, have a 600 horsepower. Capable fuel injector and a fuel pump and make 600 horsepower. You don't want to be at that maximum level in your fuel system. But one aspect that people kind of don't think about is the drivability and idle quality from a fuel injector. Once you start going much bigger than 1,000 cc or 1,300 cc, you're going to start trading off drivability and idle quality. In a race car, who cares? You don't spend much time below 2,000-3,000 RPM. So the drivability in the idle quality aren't really much of a factor. But if you're driving your car every day, if you're in stop and go traffic, if you just start your car up in the morning and you're idling, you don't want a super lumpy idle because your injector just isn't happy running, at a leaner air fuel. You don't want to give up fuel economy so that your fuel injector will run a little bit smoother. A lot of guys want to throw, like a 2,200 cc injector in, on pump gas. And, you can make it work. It works, but it's not going to be as smooth as a 1,000 cc or 1,300 cc size injector. And there's trade-offs to everything. So you have to be realistic in your horsepower goal and, drivability. You got to keep both in mind. So sizing your fuel pump for your fuel system is another critical aspect of making sure that everything is kind of working together properly. You want to make sure your fuel pump is large enough, to support the power that you need, but you want to make sure that your fuel pump can sufficiently feed your fuel injectors enough fuel for the horsepower you need. So, for example, our drag S2000 that we have, we were making right around 950 horsepower. We had two sets of 2000 cc injectors. We had a Bosch 044 pump feeding each rail or each set of fuel injector. We were completely fine at that power level. We upgraded the turbo. We made about 12 to 1300 horsepower with the new turbo in place. On the dyno, I only ran the car around 40 pounds or so. We were making, just shy of 1,200. We took it to the track, and we started running into fuel pressure problems. Our fuel pressure was dropping off, and we were running about 55 to 58 pounds of boost on the car. We thought the fuel pumps were bad. We thought the regulator was bad. We thought, all the things were bad. We actually replaced the fuel pumps. We replaced things in the fuel system. And after further inspection, our fuel pump literally could not flow enough to keep up with the fuel injector. So the fuel injector itself was actually the fuel pressure drop, so to speak. So we were losing fuel pressure from the fuel injector being opened so much. You need to make sure that when you do size your fuel pump, you're sizing it adequately for your fuel injector size and your horsepower goals. There's all kinds of fuel pumps, out there. So, just pick one that's going to be appropriate for what you're doing. So when you upgrade your fuel pump in your car, chances are the fuel pump is going to draw more amperage because it flows more and it requires more voltage, more amperage. OEM fuel pump wiring is typically a small gauge wire, anywhere from 24 to 18 gauge, maybe being at the high end or thickness of the wiring. A lot of these performance fuel pumps need a much larger gauge wiring to sufficiently flow, what the rated pressure and flow is from that pump. So I recommend to upgrade the fuel pump wiring through a relay so that you can achieve what the fuel pump is advertised to flow for flow and pressure, and you're not left having an issue with fuel pressure dropping or other issues of burning up the wiring in the car, for example, because the wiring physically can't handle the amperage load that's drawn on it. So one of the most common injector sizes that I tune with are 1,000cc injectors, whether they're Grams or Injector Dynamics. A lot of our customer base has a 1,000cc injector in their car, mainly because they can support roughly up to like 550 to 600 horsepower on a gas application, and they have awesome drivability. So once they're tuned, they'll idle, they'll drive, like a stock injector would, and they'll get stock-like fuel economy. There's a myth, I don't know where it started or whatever, but a lot of people think that a 1,000cc injector is too big. If we're talking about 10 years ago with like an RC 1,000cc injector, you would give up idle quality and drivability with that style injector. But with the new generation of saturated style injectors coming out in the last 6 years or so, you don't give up any idle and drivability and fuel economy. So, if you're sizing your fuel system, even if you're all motor or a supercharger that you wouldn't need a 1,000cc injector, if you're buying the fuel injector, you're not going to pay any more for a 1,000cc compared to like a 550cc. You might as well get the 1,000 because once you're tuned, the car will run the same as having the smaller size injector. So if you're planning on building a really high power street car, something in excess of 800 to 900 horsepower, you want to have awesome drivability, awesome starting, awesome idle, things like that, you should consider doing an 8 injector or a stage injector setup. So in this configuration, you would run your primary set of fuel injectors could be something like a 1,000 or a 1,300cc injector for good idle quality, good drivability, and then you stage or turn on the secondary set of fuel injectors. So you might have a set of 2,000cc's. You won't give up any drivability or idle quality because these other injectors would be brought in under 8 or 10 pounds of boost. You're half throttle, full throttle, whatever. You're not going to give up anything doing a fuel system like this. So it's basically combining the best of both worlds. It's the best of a smaller size injector that you're going to have that good drivability and idle quality, and the best of being able to deliver a tremendous amount of fuel for a lot of power. And we have found, several of our clients' cars building them this way has given them what they have wanted out of their car. There's been a myth over the years that your stock fuel lines are going to be restrictive and you're not going to be able to make as much power as you should. Particularly, this goes for a lot of import side of things. The feed line is typically a 3/8 size, which is equivalent to like a number 6 in an AN. A number 6 can flow, up to 700-800 horsepower worth of fuel, so it's not going to be restrictive. Changing out your fuel lines is certainly not a bad idea if you want to do, an aftermarket regulator, an aftermarket fuel rail, or you just want to get rid of, lines that potentially may be corroded, or if you're running like ethanol or alcohol, running a line that's designed to work with alcohol is a good idea. But the idea that the factory line is going to be ultra restrictive and you're not going to be able to make what you should is completely untrue. So a lot of the newer cars that are made have a returnless fuel system. So they don't have a externally mounted fuel pressure regulator with a return line going back to the fuel tank. They have an electronic regulator or mechanical regulator located inside the fuel tank that regulates the fuel pressure. These type of systems aren't a one-to-one system, so they don't increase fuel pressure for an increase in manifold pressure. What ends up happening is, not having a one-to-one reference, makes the injector effectively flow less because you have to overcome positive pressure in the manifold with a fuel injector. So you get less out of a fuel system with a returnless style fuel system than compared to a return style. If you were able to make 600 with a set of thousands and a 255 pump, let's say, in a return style fuel system, you would probably only be able to make roughly, maybe 440 to 450 horsepower in a returnless fuel system. So you get to a certain point with a returnless that you actually have to do a conversion to a return style, add a external regulator, you have to add a return line back to the fuel tank to allow for higher power levels. I would advise you to be aware of a lot of people that try to sell you fuel system components. Majority of them are not going to be tuners. They're not going to have experience day in, day out dealing with the quality of idle or drivability of a particular brand injector, or maybe the reliability of a particular fuel pump. There's a lot of things to consider with fuel injection. And unfortunately, shopping around for the best price on, say, a 1,000cc injector is probably a bad idea. I can say from extensive experience, Injector Dynamics is the best. They are the best because they run the best. They will run your motor smoother and better than anything else in comparison that's on the market. Especially when you start jumping up in bigger CC fuel sizes and Injector Dynamics really shows the difference. In a 2200 CC injector, the difference between another brand is almost night and day. So, when you're shopping for your fuel system components, just keep in mind you want to talk to somebody who has experience. You don't want to just be buying it from, somebody that's just selling parts online. They're not going to know the answers. They're not going to have the technical background to really give you the proper product sale. If you have any questions, feel free to, shoot us an email or give us a call. We're actually going to have a tech article based around this video, so you're going to be able to check out some more technical information if you're looking for particular sizing of fuel pumps or injectors. We're going to have a write-up there that you're going to be able to follow and be able to take something for your build out of it.